thank you for this, and David, thank you for putting my name forward. It's an extraordinary honor. I was talking to my children before I came, and they said, "Where are you going?" And I said, "I'm going to get an award for the work that we do and the work that I do." And they said, "Talking on the radio?" Apparently so, yes. We at Metro Morning and at CBC Toronto, at CBC Radio, and I in particular, are really proud of the work that we do in reflecting communities in this city. And it seems very obvious, the work that we do, and yet the more that I talk about it, the more that I think about it, and the more that I travel, I realize that it's not obvious at all. I was in Germany with Peter Slowly not so long ago. We were there with a delegation from the Maitre Foundation, traveling through Germany, speaking to broadcasters and civic leaders and people in that country about how we as a city welcome newcomers, embrace diversity, and recognize that that is part of who we are. The fabric of Toronto is made up of the threads represented by people from around the world. And it was remarkable in speaking with people there because they thought that our story was a groundbreaking one and, in their eyes, an astonishing one. They couldn't believe how open we were and how excited we were about the possibility of that sort of reflection and celebration. And I talked about many things, but one of the stories that really captured people was about football. I was speaking earlier with somebody here about soccer and football and how during the World Cup, Canada's never in the World Cup. So, because our soccer team is terrible. But every 4 years, we in the city celebrate the World Cup. And we celebrate it by having flags on the sides of cars. And you have Portuguese flags, you have Turkish flags, you have Italian flags, you have Greek flags. And we would never blink an eye or bat an eye to that. That is just part of who we are. And in speaking about that, it was a real eye-opener to hear back from people saying, "Well, that's impossible. Why aren't you upset that there are Canadian flags?" Well, because that is who we are. Those flags are part of our story. And your story is our story. And that's sort of the work that we try and do on our program every single morning, and the work that we try and do at our station every day. And there's a couple of reasons why you have to do that. One is because we're a public broadcaster, and we are owned by you, the public, paid by you, the public. And if we don't look and sound like you, the public, then we're not doing our job, and we might as well turn the lights out when we walk out the door. But it's also in this city, for me at least, something that I love, that I feel as though my city is a city of neighborhoods and a city of communities. And part of my enjoyment of the city is celebrating in those communities. So whether it's being in Kensington Market, as I was yesterday, eating Chilean empanadas in the street, and seeing people from around the world marvel at the collision of communities there, or going north of Highway 7 with my kids and eating Chinese food in a strip mall, or heading out to Scarborough and standing in line at a Sri Lankan restaurant with people who I have no connection with, I don't speak a language at all, but I know there's a lineup and I know the food's going to be good. That to me is about living in Toronto. It's about celebrating those neighborhoods and those communities. And for me, I shouldn't say this too loud, but I can't believe that I'm paid every day to do something like that and talk about that on the radio. It's a great honor to do that. It's also our job to do that. And I can't imagine a better city to do that in than this one. We have an amazing story to tell. And I say this occasionally, we do a pretty good job of running our town down sometimes and talking about the negatives in this city. The city has an incredible story to tell when it comes to how we welcome people, how we bring people in, and how we understand that your story is our story. And our story is made up by all of those stories. And the more we talk about that, the better city we're going to have. Thank you for this. It inspires me and will inspire our team, and I accept it on behalf of the great folks, including Laura Brown, the producer of Metro Morning, who's here, Robert Fisher, who does extraordinary work in the afternoon, and I wish I was still working with him in the afternoon, only in part because he's so easy to take things from. We bet on hockey and sports. Robert always loses tonight for coffee. I accept it on behalf of everybody at CBC Toronto, and I only say this is a wonderful place to live in. Stand up for your city and understand that your city is unique in that regard, that we are trailblazers, we are groundbreakers when it comes to diversity and multiculturalism, and that's something that we should champion. Thank you very much. And I apologize, but I have to leave soon because I have to get up at 3:30 in the morning. I know that sounds painful, And it is.
Thank you very much, Matt. I think by your applause, pretty clear indication the people in this room believe that IDI Toronto had picked the right person for this award. And we have one more to go from a gentleman and an organization that make a huge